Now we get to the final part of the lesson, and in this part, I want to talk about well-known ineffective development practices. These practices, when followed, tend to lead to predictably bad results. So let's look at some examples of these classic mistakes. And we're gonna start with mistakes involving people. And notice that there is a long list, so I'm going to discuss just a few of those mistakes. And I'm gonna point you to more information on this topic in the class notes. And some of these mistakes are actually kind of entertaining, so I will recommend that you look at the class notes and go in more depth in this list. So the first people mistake I want to mention is the one that I define heroics. And this refers to too much emphasis on can-do attitudes. So this idea that one person by himself or by herself can do everything and can make the difference in the whole project. And unfortunately, this encourages extreme risk-taking and discourages cooperation, which is plain bad for the project. For example, it might force people not to report scheduled sleeps, it might force people to take on too much responsibility, and normally, and I saw it happening many times, the final result is failure. So what you want when you're developing a larger project is actually to apply software engineering principles, have teams, have teamwork, and have cooperation among the different team members, without pointing too much on single individuals. Another classic mistake is not to create the right working environment. We all like to work in nice environments, and there is strong evidence that the working environment can play a big role in productivity. There is evidence that productivity increases when the workplace is nice, quiet, warm, and welcoming. Finally, some of the most important people-related mistakes are due to poor people management. For example, lack of leaderships, or leadership that is exercised using the wrong means in the wrong way, which can lead to very unhappy personnel and therefore low productivity, or even people leaving teams. Another classic example of poor management is adding people to a project that is behind schedule, which never works. Why it doesn't work? Because these new people need to be brought up to speed, and that causes further delays rather than improving the situation with the project schedule.